was born in August 2020, so right during the middle of the COVID lockdowns.
Okay, ready?
From the beginning, we knew that there was something going on with Noah. By about 6 weeks or so, she was just crying all the time. By about 8 weeks, we were concerned that there was something wrong with her vision. She wasn't looking at us, she would look through us. That then led to concerns about weight gain. She wasn't gaining weight appropriately, concerns about her missing milestones. And we really had a hard time connecting all the dots. At 11 months, we were able to have her have an MRI, which is when she was able to be diagnosed with Canavan disease. When we got that diagnosis, it was like, oh my God, this connects all those dots.
Canavan is such a rare disease. It's a couple of hundred, maybe, people in the whole wide world.
I started working on Canavan disease in 1989. Then in 2017, we developed our clinical usable gene therapy vector.
The day we got the diagnosis, she said to us, but there's a trial. She's like, you know, they're enrolling kids. We were like the first family to be given this idea that there was something that you could do. All the other families were told, just go home and love your kids, there's nothing to do. But for us, it was, there's a trial. There's something on the horizon that's actually could make a difference.
From when she got gene therapy to now, which is a little bit over a year now, you know, this is not the child that was on the trajectory that she was on in June of 2022 when she got dosed. And to see her now, I mean, she's walking. Canavan kids don't walk. Canavan kids don't sit like this.
This is probably the first time I saw what I'd never seen before. I feel very emotional.
We used to have to worry a lot more about her.
We can never, ever, ever thank them even close to enough for what they have done for our family.